again A stands for assurance. That is school quality assessment and assurance. SQA is a commitment by the Central Board of Secondary Education to provide global parameter of attainment as standards in the schools affiliated with it. SQA is expected to bring a paradigm shift in quality scenario of Indian schools. What is SQA? A school quality assessment and assurance is a self-assessment tool which lay down a set of standards, best practices for attaining individual institutional excellence. It aims to provide quality education to students through standardized instruments and process of self-evaluation and further develop an effective system. CBSE has made SQA accreditation compulsory for all affiliated schools through circular. These are the circular numbers. The first edition of SQA was published in the year 2019 and it has to be implemented by 2020, duration once in every 3 years. Educators face tremendous challenges to broaden students' perspective, catalyze innovation, encourage the students to think differently, live in a world of interconnectedness. Vision, quality scenario, through standardized instruments, self-evaluation, and as well as external assessment, benchmark in the concept established for running effective systems within an institution in accordance with the changing socio-economic and cultural context. Because nowadays the social objectives prepare the students for an increasingly complex and interdependent world. Second, reflect and review the school's process at a periodic intervals. That means what we have been taught in the BEd, that is action research. Sometimes we have to think about our process, that is it working or is it not working, or if it is not working, what are the things we have to process it, what are the things we have to delete. Devise strategies to become incubators of innovation through Kishore Vaigyanik Prosahan Yojana, NTSC. These are the things we can channelize the students for the new innovation. We can inspire them. Assess and endorse the schools as learning organization to meet that establishment standards. Each and every institution has got its establishment standards. Develop individual through collective responsibility. If we are developing a student, it is the responsibility of all the teachers, not only a single teacher or the management. Accountability in ensuring the learning outcomes of the students. This is the ABPS Group of Schools objectives, more or less it is said. One that I want to read it out, that is the quality educational opportunity through a school's mapping. And vision to impart quality education to the learners. And the last one is more important, formulate an action plan to bring institutional excellence. Because if you want to succeed, if you want to achieve our goal, we have an action plan. If we don't have the action plan, we can't attain our goals. The domains of SQA, the SQA domains is totally divided into 8 domains. The first one is the scholastic domain. It is of 25%. Second domain is co-scholastic. It is of 15%. Third is infrastructure with 10%. Fourth is human resource with 10%. Fifth is inclusive practices with 10%. Sixth is management and governance with 10%. Seventh is leadership with 10%. And 8th is beneficiary satisfaction with 10%. This is the assessment cycle of SQAA. First, you have to review yourself. Then, the reflection will come out. Then, the response. And then, you have to rate yourself. And now, I will elaborate it, the review. Review, you have to go through three questions. Where we are now? What are we doing? Why are we doing? Second one, the reflect. Four questions are there. Where do we want to go? What is working? And what is not working? That is also a very important thing. And where do we want to be? What is our near goal? Are we achieving our near goal or not? Third one, third one is respond. How are we going to get where we want to be? And the fourth one, rate. That is, how do we evaluate our efforts? The efforts we are putting, is it sufficient? Or we have to put some more efforts? Is what we are doing making a difference? That is also the main thing. After getting the rate, we have to think about the two questions. That the first one is that, how do we evaluate our efforts? And second one is that, is what we are doing making a difference or not? Now the core members of learning team. The learning team comprises of 8 core members. That is, member of representative of the school management, principal, one teacher from each level, primary, secondary, senior secondary, and middle also. One student from each level, primary, middle, secondary, and senior secondary. One teacher from co-curricular domain. One counselor, special educator, health personnel. Two members of parent teachers association. One representative from administration. These are the domain which I have earlier told you. The 8 domains. That is, the first domain is scholastic process with 25%. 13 questions are there, item levels questions, and maximum score is 52. Core scholastic process, 15%. 14 questions are there, maximum marks 56. Infrastructure, 10%. 14 question, maximum marks 56. Human resource, 10%. 11 questions, 44 marks. Inclusive practices, 10%. 7 questions, 28 marks. Management and governance, 10%. 13 questions, 52 marks. Leadership, 10%. 5 questions, 20 marks. Beneficiary satisfaction, 10%. 7 questions, 28 marks. Total questions, 84. And maximum marks is 336. This is the description level of giving the marks. We have to give assess ourselves from the parameter is 1, 2, 3 and 4. If you are giving, I will start from 1. If you are giving 1 marks, that is inceptive, system is at initial stage. Practices are individual based. If you are giving 2 marks, that is transition, system is in early constructive years, practices are generally corrective in nature. 3 marks, that is stable, evidences of database improvement process, system is defined and documented, people, teaching and learning process, students' performance, assessment of learning outcomes and feedback. This is the score which we have given in the last session, that is 2021, and that is the scorecard I am sharing it to you. Next one is course policy process, and the sub-subdomains are curriculum and pedagogical planning, art education, work education, skill enhancement, mainstream physical education and sports, life skill education. Now domain 3, with infrastructure, we are having subdomains. Sub-subdomains are classroom, library, laboratory, computer labs and ICT facilities, principal's office, staff room, administrative office, furniture, lighting and ventilation, disaster management provisions, safety provisions, playground and sports facilities. Now domain 4, it is human resource, and sub-subdomains are school staff, teaching and non-teaching, parents, students, alumni, community. Inclusive practices, the sub-subdomains are barrier-free environment, games, sports and other recreational facilities, transportation facilities, overcoming attitudinal barriers. Now the sixth one, management and governance, the sub-subdomains are vision and mission statement, institutional planning mechanism, effective coordination, resource management, relationship management, activity management, oral and written communication, standard operating procedures, financial administration, fee structure, admission process. Now the seventh one is leadership, scholastic and pedagogical leadership, collaborative leadership, system for ongoing quality and change management. Beneficiary satisfaction, sub-subdomains are satisfaction of students, satisfaction of teachers, satisfaction of office staff, satisfaction of principal, satisfaction of parents and alumni, satisfaction of community, satisfaction of management. Now the 5 years progression plan that we have to send to the corporate, it is the 5 years progression plan. 21-22, we are scoring 189, we are lagging behind 147 from the target mark, that is 336. 22-23, we will be scoring 227, we are lagging behind 109 marks from our target marks. 223-24, we are lagging behind 270 marks, we are lagging behind 66 marks. 24-25, the marks we will be getting 310, we will be lagging behind 26 marks, and we have given some room for the improvement because some parameters are there. We can't score, give marks, full marks to ourselves, and that's why we have to give the marks according to the documentation. Each and every level, whatever you are doing, each and every level they used to tell that you have to show your documentation, whether it is parent teachers meeting, whether you are taking a meeting, whether you are giving some appreciation to a teacher, to the student. Every record is needed in the SQAA. Without record, we can't assess ourselves, we can't give full marks to ourselves. This is the chart of progression plan, and ABPS Rela SPP, that is the progression plan. 2021, we are at the grade B school. 21-22, this session we will be in the grade B school. 22-23, we will be at the B plus. 23-24, we will be A. 24-25, we will be among the A plus schools. That means we have to practice, we have to change our practices, we have to to change the way of working we are working. Because everything, everywhere, every step, the proof is needed what you are doing. First, I have told you the three words, that is accountability, self-evaluation, and the third one, assessment. This one, the thing is that everywhere your accountability is there, whether I'm talking about the principal sir, whether I'm talking about a teacher, everyone is accountable. Without your team, without the team members, we can't attain this one, the A plus. So we have to change our working style. We must be accountable on every moment. And this is the SQA scorecard, how we have to assess ourselves. That is 301 to 336, that is A plus schools. 251 to 300, that is A school. 201 to 250, B plus schools. 151 to 200, B schools. 101 to 150, C schools. And below 100, that is group D schools. Thank you.